We've never lost anybody permanently, but it's nice to come in here and kind of feel like you've left the outside world behind and you've entered a different realm, maybe a different reality where everything is ice. Hi, I'm Brent Christensen. I'm the founder of Ice Castles, and today we're at Lake Geneva, and we are going to talk about ice castles and how we make them. When it comes to actually designing and planning an ice castle, it's a long process. Finding a location, we have to consider a ton of variables, like first of all, weather. And we say, okay, which way is the sun going to shine? Because that affects the growth. How does the prevailing wind come into play? Where are we going to put our shops, our workspace? Can we get a lot of water? Will there be a place for that water to go when it melts? And is it going to be close enough to where it can be enjoyed by the masses? It takes a while, and it takes a lot of collaboration. These massive structures, which weigh like 25,000 tons or something crazy when we're done, we get it going vertical by using icicles, which we grow. We have icicle farms. We have hundreds of valves that control sprinklers through the whole thing. We turn that on and it puts a layer of ice on everything. Those icicles, initially, they're like right on the grass going vertical. And they, as we spray water in the overnight, they grow, they blossom, they get bigger. A day later, we go back and do the same thing and add more on those until some of these towers will go up to, you know, sometimes 40 feet. To give you an idea of what it takes, aside from just turning water on and having water ice collect, there's a huge element of human labor to make this happen. This was solid ice. These overgrow, the floor will come up sometimes this high, and it has to be chopped out with a chainsaw, with picks and shovels and sporks. You know, it's literally tons and tons of ice that we have to haul out before we open. That first one I did in my yard, I was building this framework and my neighbor looked over his fence. It's like, hey, what are you doing over there? And I tried to explain to him my thought process and what I was doing. And he's just like, okay, see ya. You know, sometimes we have to ignore people and just have fun with what we do. This thing that I started as a project with my kids just to play and build ice forts has turned into this thing where, you know, at this point it's been millions of people that have been able to come and enjoy them. It's pretty amazing and pretty humbling to be a part of that. A long road, a lot of fun, a lot of trial and error, a lot of cold fingers and frozen pipes and things like that, but it's amazing to look and see where we're at now considering where it started.